Hey guys, good morning. How are you all doing? So guys, right now I am at a castle. That's the castle up there. It's called Craigmillar Castle. Unfortunately, when I went to the ticket office, they told me that the castle is not open, so it's only the grounds, which is a bummer. But you know, it's still a good day, so we're gonna see if we could get some really cool shots. And then I got this sensor tracker off Amazon, so I might just give that a try today, maybe do a little review on the channel so you guys can see what that is all about. Anyway, don't hesitate to smash that subscribe button down below. Also, turn on your post notifications so that every time that I upload a new video, you are notified. Okay guys, so guys, I mentioned that I got this sensor on Amazon. It's a 360 auto tracking holder right there. I don't know if you guys can see. So it's supposed to track your movements and while you walk, in case you don't have anyone to follow you while you record. And it's so windy, my things are flying everywhere, but I'm just gonna quickly set it up for you guys. I already charged it. It's got like a regular what's it called, USB charging ports at the back here. You're supposed to turn it on right there, push that button, it turns on. So I don't know if you guys can see the lights on there, probably not, but there are two lights on right now, so it's on. And I'm just going to place my phone on top of it, set my camera to video mode like so, push record. And we're gonna move right now. So guys, keep your eyes on this bad boy right here, okay? To see if he moves while I'm walking. Okay. Okay. Let's see how fast he can go. That was bad. Okay, so we're gonna try one more time. I don't think I set it up right. I'm supposed to have used, there's a latch behind you that I'm supposed to use to support my phone. This time around I'm going to try it on my tripod, and I'm hoping that my phone doesn't fall on the ground. And see what I'm supposed to use to support my phone, that latch over there. I don't know if you guys can see, I'm supposed to do something like that. I've put my phone on there. Okay, so I don't know, you guys can see it's a lot more sturdy. Okay, let's go. I'm gonna stand to give you guys my final thoughts while I'm moving, because that's the idea, like that's the reason why I got it. Yeah. Okay, so let's go. So in terms of what it says it actually does it, because as you guys can see, I'm talking and I'm walking and it's following me. The only thing I'm gonna say is when it comes to activities that are quite fast, like you didn't catch that. See, I'm gonna try one more time. Yeah, it kind of loses me. So yeah, it's not that fast, but it would do the basics, like, oh, I'm talking and I'm recording and nobody's behind the camera but it's following me, and you know, I'm showing you guys this beautiful castle behind me, and it's working, it's doing what it's supposed to do. But anything like intense, like races, horseback riding and stuff like that, following like fast animals like birds and stuff, it's not gonna work. But yeah.
still am currently here. Murder most royal in November 1566. Mary Queen of Scots rode into this courtyard seeking peace and security. She had come to stay with her loyal supporters, Sir Simon Preston, at a time of terrible stress. After falling ill, she remained here to recuperate. During Mary's illness, her lords are said to have hatched a plan to get rid of her vain, violent, and ambitious husband, Henry Lord Dundee. Their scheme would go down as one of the most notorious plots in Scottish history, known as the Craigmillar Bond. It would shape Mary's life and end Dundee's. No one knows exactly how old the two majestic youths in the court garden are, but some legends connect them with the visit of Queen Mary of Scots in 1566. The earliest record of them is from 1890, by which time they were already notable. Almost all parts of the yew tree are poisonous. The seeds within the red jelly-like berries are dangerously toxic.
Oh wow, okay.
The Preston's Pleasure and Parkland. In front of you, the earth has been designed into the shape of a P. It is thought to stand for Preston, the name of the family that fueled Craigmillar and lived here for two centuries. The P-shaped ornament formed the focal point of the castle's pleasure gardens and parks.
This is supposedly Mary Queen of Scots. Obviously, you can see people drinking, eating, and all that jazz. I can't see the P shape though. Like, I can't see any P shape. Maybe it's because like the weeds have, you know, covered it or whatever, but yeah, I could see the, can you guys see the, like, I don't know if you guys can see that, but yeah, that's the pleasure park light right there.
Water of life. This well was the castle's main supply of fresh water. People could come from the castle through a side door, which has now been blocked up to draw water. Private Gilmore Burial Isle. Ah, okay, let's go read it, guys. We're here for the facts, okay? A time for prayer. This small chapel was built in the early 1500s and provided a place of worship for the castle residents. Place of rest. The castle continues to be used as a burial place for the Gilmore family, the last owners of the castle. Degrees of separation. The chapel would have been divided by a timber screen. Members of the castle household could worship at this end. Beyond the screen was the chancel, the holiest part of the church, containing the altar. Only priests and the richest benefactors could enter there. Family faith. The Prestons demonstrated their Christian devotion by supporting local churches. Sir William Craigmillar's Laird, 1442 to 1453, gave St. Giles Cathedral an Ambone said to have belonged to St. Giles himself. After William's death, the cathedral's Preston Isle was built in thanks. This crucifix, dating to the 1400s or 1500s, was found here at Craigmillar. Okay. So that's the entrance, guys. I don't know if you can see. Private Gilmore Burial Isle. Thank you, then. Enjoy the rest of your day. Bye. That's the end of this video. Bye, guys.